Pase simi nga motema mama o alingi boye o Lokutana ya mabe mama masumu o duble duble Kolinga moto zalili sumu te pona nino driblenga boye your matu Bayemba, bayemba, bale mina koyemba likolo na yo tika enzo mama Mesa kamo te manenge nini yol mao Duble duble o Kome la kangata nikolo ya poso mama o Duble duble Esa kamo beze lita manaka chua o Duble duble Soki o pesi na ya lole muwana na komine sika na linga kayo
Maria Masane
Na bamba na bamba na mote mana kokate tika na bimisa o mama Mama na bamba na bamba na mote mana kokate tika na bimisa o mama
Mama Ingénieur Tumba Kinkela.
I just love being some Liberia.
Au cas de chargement.
Beautiful country. Rich country. Greedy leaders. Corrupt people. That just don't give a damn about this country. And that's why the poor people will continue to suffer in their own country. Leaders will come and leaders will go. Who really loves Liberia, folks? You just can't trust anybody. This is so sad for Liberia. And I just feel sorry for the vulnerables. Something you just want to leave and don't turn back to Liberia because of wicked people.
Oka.
Hey, man.
Hiya.
Ladies and gentlemen, please allow me to borrow the wordings of the wise men. Tough times don't last, tough people do. The heart of a man is never known until he rises. Because there's no second chance to make that first impression. You can't hide your nakedness from beefing bucket. When God bless you, don't say that medicine. A bald-headed man does not walk on the moonlight. When you see crawfish come from under the water and say the crocodile here sweating, don't say the lie. Basi yon plou. Sekouli. Aye pelio. Nisi apo krike akpake yo to dry adiwa adiwa apo ule no muzu ani wo je matobo to dry mo jimi adre nwo klo ya dueblo to dry yo adiwa adiwa apo the medicine of the microphone, the golden voice of Liberia, the brother who doesn't eat iron, he's definitely the stronger than a lion. Ask for the giant. that now you know me in garlic. Welcome.
Soki opesima ya lole mwana na komi nesika na linga kayo.
Maria Masane.
Na bamba na bamba na mote mana kokate tika na bimisa o mama.
And we all know what happened. It started, you are trying to play now, you better stop it. I know your boss man is not happy.
Hey.
And he has instructed you to do something different. Please don't. The people have spoken.
Engineer Tumba Kinkela.
Oh, you see, get up.
And that's what, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to say a big thank you to Top FM in Zwetu Grand Jeter County. I also want to say a big thank you to Live FM 104.1. And want to say a big thank you to Joy at 101.5 FM as well. And this time, please join me in as I introduce to you my co-host, Volcano Shelton. Shelton, hello and welcome to the show.
Yeah, good afternoon, Ashford. Good evening. Good night in Liberia. I know it's because it's night side there, probably 10 o'clock or a little after 10. Well, man, listen, I just heard you say something about people trying to listen to the boss, they're playing hanky-panky, they're dragging things. But hopefully the Elections Commission don't see okra and swallow dry bone. You understand me? So your wise man saying, hopefully the Elections Commission don't see okra and swallow dry bone. Let them focus on the counting of the ballot, hope and bring the result to the Liberian people. Everyone is anxious to know now who is the winner. And tonight is post-elections topic. We're going to be talking about some of the things that you witnessed during the elections yesterday, today, and the anticipation from the public. So it's good to be back here tonight.
You know, Shelton, it is very clear that even some of the folks who are seditions came out today and said, you know what, we read a blunder. We didn't do what we had to do. And we believe the president is pissed off and he will make some decisions in firing some people. And we spoke to one of those frustrated and disappointed seditions today. We have the video, and I think we should go to the video and listen to this gentleman, Shelton. And then we can come back and talk about it some more. Take a listen to what this gentleman had to say today.
Hey, I want to have a conversation with you.
This is free trade in Africa.
What do you think went wrong today?
Our when it comes to CDC, our party, our party will not really, you know, will not really do our homework. Thank you.
Now,
people want to go meet people to talk to them, to motivate them for the election, but they never did it.
What happened? Why did they do that?
Yeah, they never did it because the high hitting agenda.
What is CDC the high hitting agenda?
Yeah, thank you. Some of them were pretending as they are citizens. But you know, they know the most when they went to the pool.
So what the president thinking now? How did the president
think? Nathaniel McGee. Yeah. I mean, there wasn't coach. All the pool will be sacked. They know why. Wow. They were on the forefront of everything by the NCDC.
Thank you for talking to me today.
Yes, okay. I'm Bill Mova. Okay. Yes,
solution. Thank you.
All right.
They have started speaking, and they are upset, they are angry that they didn't do what they had to do. They trusted the people to do what they had to do, but unfortunately, people were pretending as if they were in the interest of CDC. You just heard the gentleman spoke.
Yeah, but listen, the guy, he knows, you know, I think the popularity got sentimental. You know, when you think you're so popular, there's no need to do anything. But you fail to realize it's 3.5, almost 4 years gone by. And the people are not stupid. They can see, they can feel, and they can think. Irrespective of them being silent, just like you are, they're not going to say what they want to say publicly, but they're going to go in that ballot booth and make their actions known and their decision known as to what they want to do. So this guy is right. I think they were riding on popularity, and they didn't do the homework. You saw it. You said the T-Fi went the Jehovah Witness style, but maybe it was not enough. Darius Dillon had substance he was putting forth. He talked about, you know, changing the status quo. I saw a video of him voting. He didn't boycott the line. He didn't come in because he's the senatorial candidate and went ahead of the line. Even people said, why don't you go? He said, no, I'll wait my time. All right. And so I think that's what this guy is talking about. People need to do what is right by the people. And then the people will respect and give you the opportunity to serve them. And I think going forward, this is not going to be the same modus operandi. The people are not awakened.
The guy you just listened to, people are saying he was drunk. And
he was a little zombie-like, you know, but
citizens are known to talk liquor talk.
Yeah, but listen,
sometimes when you get drunk, that's when the truth comes out, correct?
That's what I was about to say. When Moba Molu talked, he was telling the truth, but it was under the masquerade of being drunk. But you ever seen a drunken man say, I'm drunk? No.
No.
Because he's not drunk. If he's drunk, he's not going to say he's drunk. So in that case, this guy knows what he's talking. He just decided to drink his sorrow away. He decided to drink his defeat away. You understand me? But he's not. He knows what he's talking about.
Now we went to the polling stations yesterday. One polling station after another, and because of limited resources, we couldn't visit every polling station. But for the few places we went, it was free, fair, and transparent. And I had to go there, Shelton. I had to go to where the president voted, because I just wanted to see the room the president voted in. And when I got to the room, or when I got to the precinct, they said, this is where the president voted. I said, okay. How far are you in terms of the content of the ballot? So we're done with the senatorial ballots. I said, okay, let us see how these people vote. And of course, Senator Dillon had 139 votes. And Tifa have 50 votes in the very room that George Weah voted in. We're hearing now that George Weah mistakenly voted for Darius Dillon.
I mean, stop, man. you let him play, eh? This is right now what George Weah voted for Darius Dillon.
I'm telling you. You know, and the reason I say this,
they blew a dart. They play was dark when he voted.
No, the play was not dark. But you know, when you when you really want to deal with somebody and then you done made a mistake and just vote for the wrong person.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. It's possible.
The president dances this song called Zombie.
You got to play that song tonight.
The song is not, it's not for the president. The song is for Darius Jordan. The president was just borrowing the song. And Shelton, if you listen to the song, listen to the lyrics, you will hear Uncle D. And Uncle D meaning Uncle DeLon.
Okay.
So the president was always dancing to the beat of Darius Jordan. Let us take a listen to the song, Shelton.
Blessings and blessings, you're coming blessings. These my blessings can all be touching. I know my love, my man, don't stress me. If Papa bless me, I'm here to party. I won't wear yellow zombie. I won't bought it, I pro yellow zombie. But then I'll bring a yellow zombie. I got a party, people dancing yellow zombie. Sanko, me, I won't do a yellow quacko. Wait, bring the liquor. The poor man, someone pen the paper. I said no party, I won't party. I want you to go down low, I want you to find it slow. Mama, you rock the show, I'm ready to spend some more. And I'm gonna, you know, sit down, I'm gonna. Check it, see, I said no time for check, check. Man, I want you to dance like you ready, don't care. And do the dance for the zombie set. It's me and you, mama, no more stress. I want to dance after you, myself. I won't wear yellow zombie. I won't bought it, I brought yellow zombie. But then I'll bring a yellow zombie. Got a party, people dancing yellow zombie.
When I'm good, this your face. I said to them only photo.
Yeah, I give it me Uncle Dench. Uncle Dench.
Bless me. Bless me. Bless me. Bless me. You cannot stop me. Yeah. Oh, oh. You can't never go through. You say they have got no heaven, no. Papa, fire me on papa, papa, papa. Dragons are no remote and distant. I bless you first, God.
That's
for me. My blessing for the rest, bell.
You know, sit down, number left. Wait, bring the liquor. The poor man, someone spend the paper.
Wait, bring the liquor. The poor man, someone spend the paper. I said,
and Shelton, in the song, they say Uncle D show face. In the song, you also heard about the light. So George Weah ran campaign for Darius Jordan. And not only did he run the campaign for Jordan, but he went and mistakenly voted for Darius Jordan. And the room George Weah voted in, Shelton.
There we go.
We went in that room. And like I said last night, don't you shut it, you know, I'll stay out late. But I say, you know what? When anything happened, let it happen, I go out. And when I went to the Kenninger school, I said, I want to see where the president voted. They said, Kainsa. And went in there. 139 votes for Jordan and 50 votes for Tifa.
So Idi Amer will blame Moba Molu the way he has made a whole mess to go for Jordan mistakenly. I had to blame Moba Molu now. And Molu better keep his word. He said he will resign.
Exactly. The question now is, who will become the new chairman for CDC? By the time we get there,
this is a high class drama. High class drama. So what are the delay for the county now? What are the election commission doing now? What going on here?
Well, Shetan, this does not only happen in third world countries. It happens all over the world. So the election commissioners are taking their own time, and they want to be very careful in terms of the tabulation. So let us give them, you know, get them some chance as they count these votes. But there will be no way that you can cheat. The poll watchers were there, both from the opposition and the ruling establishment. I met them and they said, you know what, the process was free, fair, and transparent.
But and where that's are coming they from all sides?
Of course.
Including the CDC watchers, they said the of same course. Thing.
Brother, I spoke with both of them. But where are they coming from now with the celebration? If you notice today, the DJ at the CDC headquarters started playing all kind of music, and they couldn't understand the music. They say he was hungry. And for the first time, we saw DJ being hungry at the headquarters of the CDC. It was like a complete ghost town. I said, but where are all these people? Every day, Christmas at the CDC headquarters. But go find the people. You know, but again, there were a lot of things on the ballot. George Weah took the Liberian people for granted. And I said this, I will continue to say this. Don't protest. Every time you have the opportunity to go to election,
go.
Go. Because you are the employer. These people work for you. And it is so unfortunate that they don't care about you. It's all about themselves. So when you go out there to vote, put country first. And I think that's what happened yesterday. Shelton?
Yeah, so, I mean, the people have spoken. Let's wait to see the result. But from the overwhelming tune around the country, and especially in Monserrate County, it seems as though Darius has won. But again, we can't speculate until the Elections Commission comes out with the final tally and declare the winner. But we hope that it's not going to take that long, because in as much as the elections was quick, there was no accordingly, no violence anywhere. Everything went smoothly. It shouldn't take them days to count, you know, the votes. That stuff should be done just like the guy who you interviewed from the Elections Commission told you that they're professionals. They have all the, you know, systems in place. They were poised. They were ready, you know, to carry on these elections. I don't think that there should be long-standing counts and have the public answers, you know, for days. They need to come out. But Ashford, let's move from Monserrate County. What do you know about Grand Bassa? What do you know about Kip Mount, Sano, and that of Bapolu and Lofa and Grand Gida, your home county?
Well, let me begin with Grand Cru. I spoke with some people in Grand Cru, people who are very credible, and they said to me that it is too close to call in Grand Cru. And I also spoke with some people in River G and it said Jonathan Sequoia, ball ties, is doing well.
Okay.
In River G. Now in Grand Bassa County, the people that support Yombly Kangat are celebrating, and the people that support former Foreign Affairs Minister Wesley Afeni are also celebrating. We can't come out to say who is actually winning. Now, then in Lofa County, where the people all the time, overwhelmingly, they were listening to the former vice president. And in Lofa County, former defense minister, Brandon Jeffrey Samukla, is ahead. The last time we checked, with 5,845 votes, followed by Wea Julie Fatuman with 1,637. Jones Noah, 1,541. Kupana Mariamu Bien with 1,200 votes. Gala Pato Joseph with 1,100 votes. And we also have Tengbe George with 873 votes. You know, and I think six is enough because the rest of the votes are just smaller numbers. So this is where we are so far. In Lima County, I'm told Mrs. Edith Gonklo Wed is doing extremely well. That's by the campaigning from Prince Johnson, the campaigning, you know, the message from George Weah. This lady, I'm told, is very powerful, and she's doing exceptionally well in my county.
Bomi County. I heard Evan Snow.
Bomi Snow
massacre in Mentalo, eh?
Well, they referred to Edwin Snow as a stranger in bombing. Now, because of the performance by Edwin Snow, people are already started calling him President Pro Tem. Snow knows how to work his way around. According to what we heard, if you can destroy Ellis Tyler in
his own hometown,
that alone should speak volume. Snow was one speaker. This guy knows how to get around. And Snow, my friend,
let me hear that. And I saw they took out to put Ellis Tyler there.
Exactly.
Eh? So the man come back there.
And you know, Snow has a way of getting back at you. Snow said he would not be a senator to side with the ruling establishment. And again, I said this last night, the more opposition senators you have, they will have a better shot at having this president impinge, you know, before even 2023. But then again, it has to do with the credibility about some of these senators. I know for a fact our senators, our representatives, how they are ordered by themselves and not the country and not the people. So perhaps this is just the beginning of us seeing something good to happen for Liberia. Should we then say, you know, it is not time that we can turn the page to see a better Liberia? We are hoping that this will happen. Shatan?
Yeah, so Edwin Snow has been his own man. He's been able to hold his own grounds. He was quarantined during these elections and campaigning season. And yet, if he's able to pull it off, that speaks volume. But again, when the people are tired, you know, when the people have gotten their backs pushed against the brick wall and there's nowhere to go, or they have been pushed to the tip of the cliff and the only thing left is for them to fall, they're going to go down hard. Liberian people, as much as we say they're gullible, they're meek, they're timid, you know, we're just a kind of strange people. You can only take advantage of us for so long. And when that time comes, it's like an avalanche. We've seen it time immemorial, you know. But I think the right route to go going forward is the democratic process. We don't have a crystal ball as the voting public to determine who's better. But if we put you there and you don't live up to the expectations, all we can do is go back to the ballot and remove you. And once it's done peacefully, you have no fight, you know. But let's imagine Wapu Digi was the Elections Commission chairman tonight. Had he been confirmed a personal appointment of the president, somebody who is not a Liberian, heading our Elections Commission, who claimed that he became citizen at the age of 17. No one ever becomes citizen of another country or naturalizes at the age of 17. You must be legal, an adult at 18. So all of those things, and yet he's still hanging around. But let's assume, had he been the Elections Commission chairman, Ashford, what type of result do you think would it have been? Even though people are still pointing finger at Deveado Lasana, but let's come around. Let's just think about Wabu Digi. What did he have to lose? To mess up things.
It would have been a disaster. This is a man that is not Liberian. And the president of this country still has this guy to head the Liberian Anti-Corruption Agency. We can say all we want to say about Deveada Brown Lasanan. You and I work with her. She's a professional person. I'm not going to go into her personal
absolutely not.
Personal life, but I'm telling you, this lady is professional. And we are holding her way up there to do the right thing. Poor country first. That is all we are asking. This woman was one of the commissioners when CDC lost to Ellen. And she's now the chairperson of the National Elections Commission.
Yep.
And all we can say and all we can ask is for them to do a professional piece of work to save the state, to save the country, and to save the people of Liberia. That is all we're asking, Shelton.
And you're right, Ashford. And I think that what we've seen over the last several days and up to yesterday, there's no way they can fool around. They shouldn't see okra and swallow dry bone. They need to do the ballot counts, and they need to do it transparently, and they need to give the result, and they shouldn't drag. Because, again, if there were several irregularities at the polling stations, then you can say, oh, yeah, we're trying to fix these things. But the elections went smooth, uncontested, no violence. So they have enough time now to put, you know, to work their employees and get these ballots counted and not have the Liberian people anxious and come up with the result. So we're looking at probably tomorrow or Friday the latest. What do you think?
Except for one of the polling stations in Matadi, where we were called and we heard that some of the ballot boxes, you know, were pre-marked. People influence of Thomas Fowler. And when we got there, we spoke with the opposition poll watchers and spoke with the CDC poll watchers. Even the National Election Commission said they saw it, and people came and took those ballots out of the counting. So go, and then going forward, things were smooth. And out of the places that we went as Bridge Radio Africa, we heard both the opposition and the ruling establishment representatives telling us that the process is free, it's fair, and transparent. So, hey, I can't be in all of the polling stations at the same time. We don't have the capacity to do so. But at least the places that we've visited, the people said things were calm and they were impressed with the voting process.
Do you think we're opening the lines tonight if there were one or two voters who might want to call in, you know, just to chime in and tell us what their experience was yesterday? Is that the intent tonight?
And I think we should begin doing that now.
Yeah,
we should begin doing that. And as I try to pin the number, just go ahead and speak to our folks.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you just joining us, this is Bridge Radio Africa. We're coming live via Facebook and YouTube, and then several local radio stations in Liberia, Top FM, Live FM, Super FM. We've been covering the elections over the last few days up to yesterday when the electorates went to the polls to vote the candidates of choice. Accordingly, Darius Dillon was in the lead. There was Brownie Samuka in the lead. Yumbly Kanga Lawrence was in the lead. All of these folks were in the lead. But as of yet, the elections result has not been produced by the National Elections Commission. They're still counting accordingly. My thought around it is that we hope that it doesn't take forever, because then it will present some kind of anxiety to the public, and then there could be cries of foul play. So we hope that they will be speeded with this process and get the results out as soon as possible. For those of you, our viewers and listeners around the world, we want to welcome you tonight. We're all in prayers for Liberia. We think that our country is at a standstill, and it's important that we keep the country in prayers. The economy is in shambles. People who are coming from Liberia are saying that it's like during the post-war days prior to Taylor coming to power, when everything was just helter-skelter. Electricity is far from the truth. You know, communities are going to bed at night by 5-6 in the evening. People don't want to be out because of the security risk. You and I know that missing boys are still no head, no tail from their stories. It's been 2 months now. 4 auditors died. Another police commander was found dead, and it's construed to be suicide. So just so many things going on in the country. Corruption is at its peak. Bribery is everywhere. There's no money, especially our local Liberian dollars can be found. The banks cannot release money. ATMs are not releasing money. So much just going on, and it's all negative. So we just want to encourage you, our listeners and viewers all over the world, all over the country in Liberia, to continue to pray for the country. Let us transition smoothly through to 2021. We understand that there's a resurgence of COVID in the country. It's important that you folks wear your mask and stay safe. Ashwell, you back?
Yes, of course, we're back. And folks, if you just joining us, the telephone number to call, especially if you want to call in via WhatsApp, call in on +231 888 238 5525. If you are located in Liberia and you want to be a part of the program, call us on 0888 238 8525. Those are the numbers to call. And again, Shelton, you know, and I know that we're here because of the support from the board of Bridge Radio Africa. And I want to say a big thank you to our board chair. This lady is very hardworking. She has been very instrumental in helping us out, especially with the facilitation of us being here, you know, and the rest of the board members. So, listen, I know you say we do a good job, but visit the cash app. They're dropping a little something. 302-494-3760 or I was Zelle at 313-408-8396. Any data what they can put a fire. Or go to Bridge Radio Africa LLC on their Facebook page and just like a few stars. You know, like a few stars and show us some love. Listen, the things that we are doing for Liberia, you know, you can do them too. You know, but hey, somebody has to do it. So why don't you show us some love? With that said, I think we need to go to the telephone line now. We have 9200. It's the last four digits of the number. Hello, caller.
Hey, Mr. God, how you doing? Good evening, and how you doing?
God is good. Too blessed to be stressed. What is your name?
This is Jimmy Carden from Connecticut, the USA.
You're live on the radio. Go ahead with your concern, please.
We want to say thank you for all that you do, and thanks for covering the election. But I don't think we Liberians want to go back to where we came from. But this is not a primary, but it is a guarantee. If the ruling establishment think they can change anything to twist the election in their favor, we are willing to go extra mile to do anything so that we in the government can get into it. They don't try, we're waiting for them. We're still waiting. We're in America, we're watching, we're listening, we know what's going on, but we are watching. They didn't do anything. We always get into the street, and what we never heard for a long time, we start to hear it. We challenge them. Thank you.
Thank you, my brother. You just heard the brother shouting.
Yeah, hello. I think one of our viewers, listener, wrote that they believe that the delay in getting these votes counted is to ensure due diligence to the process so that the results can be undisputed. But again, it's possible, but you know, the Liberian man are quick to speculate, and the longer they drag,
we have a local caller on the line. Hello, caller, tell us your name.
Yeah, this is George McMillan. How are you?
Good. Too blessed to be stressed. Okay. Go ahead, make your point, please.
My question has to do with I just listened on the air and I heard from one single series on the line saying that the CDC have won and they should get together, they should assemble to the headquarters and do no celebration. Other things, those are I'm under the election commission chairman to announce results. And then the second concern has to do with printed ballot boxes, as you were talking about. What actually has become of it? Have they been disposed of, or what happened? I don't know.
Well, again, I will say this to you. We went, after we got a tip-up, we went to the Matadi Estate at the Don Bosco Youth Center, where a voter complained that there were boxes that was marked already for tea fallout. And when I spoke with the poll washers representing CDC and the CPP, they said, listen, the box was in fact disqualified. And I also spoke with the National Election Commission representatives, and they also said they took that out, and people came from NEC and took that away. So it was not included in the content of the ballot. So that's what we know so far. But the gentleman you called that said to you that CDC has won, we are still waiting to authenticate this information. Now, the National Election Commission will have to come up with a press conference in telling us about the final tally of these votes. Again, folks, I hope that answers your question. Again, folks, if you just joining us, the telephone numbers to call for WhatsApp is 231-888-238-5255. And you are in Liberia, 0888-238-5255. Shutter.
Yeah, so, I mean, quite frankly, there will be a lot of speculations, as I said, the longer it takes. So I will hope that, you know, people don't feed off on these kinds of speculations, because it has a propensity to create some kind of, you know, tension in the country, rather than wait until that final tally is done and the announcement is brought forth through the Elections Commission. And usually I think they call a press conference to make that declaration. So people shouldn't feed off some of those hearsay and bysay all around the corner, declaring CDC to be winner, or Darius Dillon to be winner, or anyone to be winner for that matter, until, you know, the Elections Commissions can bring forth the result. Now, there is a thought around, just from the sentiments during the voting yesterday, that certain people were in the lead, and they would think that people will maintain the lead. So we can hold on to that.
Hold that thought, Shachan.
Go ahead.
Go to the line. Hello, caller. Tell us your name.
Hello, I'm James Bole. I'm calling from Philadelphia, USA.
You're live on the radio. Go ahead and make your point, please.
Thank you, Ashford and Shelton, and also to the Bridge Radio family. We followed this process since yesterday up to present, and we're happy that Liberians are getting to improve the way they do things. We happy for the level of peace yesterday, and at this point we just hope, as everybody's saying, the government needs to be very responsible to listen to the people. I think the problem of this current government is people are living in denial until they can learn to accept reality. This is going to keep happening to them. And I think this government is going to be one turn. We need to accept the truth. If we err as human beings, we need to know that we've erred and try to correct it. But people are in the government and giving wrong information to the president. And the same Liberian people you want them to vote for you during election time, you treat them as if they are enemies. During normal time, you call them opposition. Be it opposition or whoever, they are all Liberians. And that's the government. The people are Liberians, and we need to treat them as one people. So if you start calling people opposition, enemy of the state, and then during election time, you want the support of the people, is wrong. And this is the only government since I've been knowing myself, I see they come up openly to start discriminating people. I hear them say Congo people. I mean, we shouldn't be doing those kind of thing. You hear them many times, the officials of government say, when the Congo people were here, now this is our time. I mean, these are wrong things we need to start. We fought for them.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, we're still in the PA area, 9096. Hello, tell us your name.
Hello.
Hello, you're live on the radio. Tell us your name.
Hello.
You're live on the radio. Please do not listen to the radio. Listen to the phone. You're live on the radio. I think he hanged up. What were you saying, Shelton? Were you saying something?
No, I said someone was still talking on it. Probably the previous caller.
The guy who, when I clicked over, he was perhaps listening to
the monitor,
and not the phone. So and you, you know, and I know that it's a little delay when it comes to that, but you just heard the concern. We want to say hi to Mrs. Hello. Hold on. Hello, caller. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You're live on the radio. Prince.
Yeah, thank you. I'm Prince Noah, calling from Liberia.
You're live. Go ahead and make your point, please.
Yeah, we are happy. Yesterday, we did our vote peacefully, and we are waiting to get our result peacefully. And we don't want no disturbance. We don't want no halahala. And we hope everything will be fine. Our right is right there in the ballot box, and we are not going for no protest. Our protest is right in our box. So our right are expressed all. Our voter card are expressed all. So we just looking up to NEC for the result, and we know it will be positive in the interest of what we did yesterday.
Thank you, sir. You know, you. And you know, Ella, we said where the candidates did well in other parts of the country, and we're hearing now in Maryland, Mr. James Bannon, who represents the NPP, is doing exceptionally well in that part of the country as well. Hello, caller, tell us your name. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, you're live on the radio. Tell us your name, please.
Yeah, I'm Dixon Washington. I'm calling from Paris, France.
Mr. Washington. Bonjour.
Yeah, thank bonjour.
Is that a bien?
Yeah, Ashford, thank you very much, man. and you and Shelton, you guys are
very good.
I just called to say that it's like a Liberia is on the edge of catastrophic. Hmm. Yeah, so
why would you say that?
I've been monitoring everything, man. I've been seeing all the negative comments that have been coming through on the social media, and they are not very good for our country. I've not been around, you know, for more than 15 years now. Never seen Liberia. And this is the only place that we have. Let me just be straight up front. Okay? The government is trying to play some kind of game. And that's not good for our country.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank
you. Hello, caller.
Mr. Gale, how you doing, sir?
God is good. Too blessed to be stressed.
Amen. I'm calling from Philadelphia, to Phyllis Fala.
You're live on the radio. Go ahead and make your point, please.
I just want to give a piece of advice to the president so that his mind can be retrospect as to the time he was running as a senator for Montserrado, when Ellen had every power and ability and strength to take that particular seat from George Weah. But Ellen looked at it to say, I will not gamble my presidency because of my son. And Ellen let it go. My advice to George Weah, Liberians have gone through a whole lot for 14 good years. Blood has been shed in our country. 250,000 lives were lost. Not because of seditions, not because of the people around him. George Weah, CDC have lost this election massively. Let them leave the people of Liberia and let their voice be heard.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Hello, caller. Hello, caller.
Hello.
Yeah, please do not listen.
Yes.
To listen to
the phone. Okay.
You're live on the radio. Go ahead and make a
point. Yeah, okay, I'm Mr. Donzo calling from Austria.
Donzo, hello and welcome to the show. Go ahead and make your point.
Yes, I want to get the final result because the rumors that circulating around social media is a little bit confusing. Since yesterday we followed the result, we are following, but the final result has never come up yet. Opposition are saying the Donald Trump has won the election, and the CDC are saying they won the election. And the leading party was CPP. The result were hearing starting from yesterday. But what is circulating now in the around social media, everybody is just choosing their party. Say our party is the winning party. So all those who are being confusion
family is not supposed to be like that.
Thank
so
you.
We just
thank you, my brother.
We need, yes.
Thank you. Your point is taken. Yes. Thank you so much. Hello, caller.
Hello, Ashford.
Yeah, you're live on the radio. Please tell us your name.
I'm Catherine Durban. I'm calling from Texas.
You're live on the radio. Go ahead and make your point, please.
Yeah, first of all, I want to say thanks to you for the hard work done back home. And I want to say thank you very much for all that you've done. And back to the election, I just want to advise George Weah and all of his advisors who are giving those advices to please not to tamper with this election. As for you, I can argue it. We can come online. We can go on Facebook. We can post on social media here and there, you know, to express our grievances. But there are other people who don't have that means, who don't know how to do it. There are other people who just want to express their, you know, their anger through some violent means.
Thank you.
And I hope we don't go that far. I'm Thank just urging the CDC government not to care all that stuff.
Thank you. Your point is well taken. Hello, caller.
Yes, this is Edward. I'm calling from Philadelphia.
Edward, you're live on the radio. Go ahead and make your point, please.
Ashley, I just want to thank you for
your work.
Sorry, Ashford. Ashford, I just want to thank you for the work you're doing out there. We're following you. And I just want to say thanks to the Liberian people for coming out and speaking. You know, a wise man once said, you know, God has his way of speaking to us if only we listen very keenly. God doesn't come these days to talk to you directly. The people of Liberia, God is speaking through the people of Liberia. And I think it is but fitting that our president listen and listen keenly. The turnout in this election and how people voted, it's time for him to hear what they are saying. Otherwise, by 2023, he will be out of a job.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Much. All right. And Chetan, I want to say to the president, I saw the crowd on Sunday when I visited the Unity Party's headquarters, and I also had the opportunity to go around the entire country, and I saw the desperation in the faces of our Liberian brothers and sisters. I started going towards the crowd. I had to balance myself because the wave of the crowd, some of the people that I spoke with, you can tell that since we are experiencing police brutality, when we go to protest, these people will come and use tear gas on us. They will beat us. Sometimes they will arrest us. This is the only time we have to send a message. They say, you know what? We are not going to protest. We are going to vote. And I am saying this to my friend and big brother, George Weah. You've had your 15 minutes of fame. The Liberian people gave you the opportunity. The people are not happy. You said, and don't say anything. People are dying. No money in the country. Shetan.
Hello.
Hold on 1 minute, sir. You have money in the bank and you can't get your money out. What is going on?
Yep.
You can't keep doing that to the people.
Yes, us.
We want to take the last caller because time has caught up with us. Hello, caller.
Hello.
How you doing? You live on the radio. Tell us your name, please.
My name is Vanny Foley, calling from Pennsylvania.
Mr. Foley, hello. You live on the radio. Go ahead and make your point, please.
Now I've just got a call from Doe Community in District 14, they said our CDC is celebrating. And as I expect now for now, I know Taron Sidon is our senator for Mozzarella County. So if George Weah make one mistake on a result of the election to rig that election, it would be a different thing in Liberia.
Thank you.
So that my message I'm giving to the government.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Hello, caller. Hello, caller. You live on the radio. 9610. 9610. Okay. Shutting. Again, tomorrow I'm going to attempt to get in contact with the authority at the National Election Commission, NEC, to bring us up to speed as to what is going on in terms of the results. You know, I go everywhere, you know, and I'm not the guy to play with when it comes to my country, you know. So we will do that tomorrow, because the people want to hear from night. We can't keep holding on. And we're just asking them to do the right thing. Do not tamper with these votes. Please don't do so. We're asking for your own trouble. Closing statement, Shelton.
You know what? I want to circle back to the guy who talked about the race, the senatorial race that President Weah participated in. I think I was in Liberia that year, and he was going against the president's son, Robert Sirleaf. Let's be practical here. That caller was very right. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf was in power. She had the Elections Commission, you know, to her fingertip. She could have done anything to make her son senator, but she decided to let the people will prevail. And President Weah then became senator and served in the Senate via Mozzarella County. He can do the same this time around, even though he glaringly said that he wanted Mozzarella County at all cost. So would this be the all cost that the Elections Commission is taking this long? Imagine it's just senatorial race. What if it was the presidency where almost the entire country had a vote, you know? So they need to work hard. They need to put some generators on tonight. They need to put some generators on and get to work and count these votes and make it as quick as possible so that they don't create any kind of tension. Because with these people coming, this camp winning, this camp celebrating, you know, it just has a serious, serious, serious consequence that could create some kind of stir up in the country. So in my closing statement, I want the Elections Commission to work tonight, put some generators on, get people in there, bring your workers, pay them overtime, whatever it is, and get these votes counted. And by tomorrow evening, be able to come out with some kind of result and let the Liberian people not be worried about who's going to be the next senator in these counties. So we hope that we'll do that.
So, Shelton, when you saw George Weah dancing the zombie dance all along, he actually borrowed a song from Darius DeLong, because you heard Uncle D, and Uncle D in the song meaning Uncle DeLong. And we're also hearing that George Weah mistaken voted for DeLong, because the very room that George Weah voted in, the result was very massive in favor of Darius DeLong. So why don't we take a few bars of the zombie song, and then we can call this a night.
Blessings, some blessings, you're coming blessings. These my blessings can all be touching. I know my love, my man, don't stress me. If Papa bless me, I'm here to party. I won't worry, you're a zombie. I won't bother, I'll cry, you're a zombie.
Button up, bring your jealous zombie. I got a party, people dancing, get a zombie.
Sanko, me, I want to wear a quacko.
Wait, bring the liquor.
The pool, I'm here, bring the liquor.
I want you to go down low. I want you to find it slow. Mama, you rock the show. I'm ready to spend some more.
And I'm gonna, you know, sit down, I'm gonna
check it. See, I see no time for check. Man, I want you to dance like you ready, don't care. Do the dance for the zombie set. It's me and you, mama, no more stress. I want to dance after myself.
I want war, yellow zombie. I want body to pro, yellow zombie. Button up, bring a yellow zombie. Body, body, people dancing, yellow zombie.
When Uncle T show face, all the children want a photo.
Yeah, yeah.
Do or die when they should be coming around. You know, you never bless me. If I pay, bless me. Yes, why bless me? You cannot stop me. Oh, yeah. Your money can never go low. You say they have, but no heaven low. Yeah, yeah. Papa, fire, man, oh, papa, papa, papa. Ragazza, no remote and this star. I bless you first, go up the transformer. My blessing full of red bell.
Man, I don't want this game. My blessing full of red bell.
Button up, bring a yellow zombie. I got a party, people dancing, yellow zombie.
I said nobody. I won't party. I want you to go down low. I want you to point this low.
Mama,
and Shutton. The librarian people just elected this board to play. I mean, who does this? You know, you come in day in, day out, and just dance zombie. Zero things are happening in our country. Shannon, do you really think this is a joke?
My man, you tell me about leadership.
where people can't get money out of the bank. You think this is a joke? I'm feeding the stuff. I'm in the country, and I'm telling you this, Shutton. I went out today to one of the local banks, and
same problem.
This was the only bank that was able to give me money. And I will call the bank's name tonight, Echo Bank.
One of the branches?
Yeah, one of the branches on the Randall Street. I think it's Randall to Ashman Street. Ashman Street, you know, right next to the former Meridian Bank, you know. And, you know, the board joined from my...
Yeah, the truck.
The truck. The second side. The same stuff happened. And the mechanic was trying to work on that, and the authorities said, listen, we have to tow this car, and tow it to the car right after the breach of our town. They wanted to pay $150, you know, to get a car out, and this guy wanted me to pay $350. So I went to the bank. I had to pay $7.50 each for two transactions.
$500 each.
The bank can only give out $240.
Oh, I thought it was $500.
The bank that I went to today on Ashman Street can only give out $240.
And then you pay $750.
Then I had to do another transaction just to get what I needed.
Wow.
The president of the country. 4 months ago, people sent out a warning that if you have money in the bank, go and take your money out. When election comes closer, they will instruct the central bank not to issue out money to the commercial banks. You got Christmas around the corner. The people are suffering. And you are angry the way the people voted today. Please, President Weir, just take this as a learning experience. You still have 1.5 or 2 or 3 more years to recalibrate. Do not tamper with these votes. Whatever happened on the 8th of December, allow the process to play itself out. Don't make it seem like you won these elections. No, it didn't happen, President Weir. We are begging you.
Especially when he made mistake and voted for Dillon.
You claim to be a god of peace. And please keep it as that. Do not tamper with these votes. The Liberian people are resolved, and they have spoken. Now, Shelton, when you want money, when you can't get money out of the bank, you know one of the places that went to get money? Tip me. Shelton, when you have relatives in Liberia, tell them to download the application called Tip Me. They will download the application, and you in Europe, America, or other parts of the world, all you have to do, just go to tipmeliberia.com.
So you download the application too on your phone?
No, you download the application, not in the States now, in Liberia. The person you're sending the money to, they will have to download the application.
Then you go via the internet.
You go via the internet and go to tipmeliberia.com.
At the website?
At the website.
Okay.
And go to somewhere they call the Top Up Center.
Okay.
And then when you see all products, it's just like you go into Best Buy or Amazon, you know, and you will add to your card. So perhaps if you want to send $200 or $300, you do that, and then you will get a top-up code. It's that code that you send to your relative in Liberia. They will easily get the money. Don't pay attention to the banks in Liberia. It's so frustrating, Shelton, I'm telling you.
So it's Tipme operating in the banks there, or is a place of its own?
Well,
and do they have branches?
They have branches.
Okay.
They have across the bridge, they have branches in Pinesville, and their headquarters is on 20th Street. When you're coming from JFK to your left hand side, by the time you get to 20th Street to your left hand side, you see Tipme. When you're coming from town, you will see the big sign that says Tipme.
And you can get money there too?
They have money all the time. Just go there and get it done, you know, simple as that.
Okay. So do they charge you for sending the money from here?
Yeah, it's a low fee, but
okay,
it's way cheaper than what the other remittance our companies will charge you.
And at least you're doing it from the comfort of your home too. You don't have to go out there standing in line like Western Union and all of that.
And with a little bit of orientation, you will see that whether it's on Sunday. And one of the things that really interests me about Tipme is I can go to most of the local supermarkets, where you will not be charged when you use your Tipme on your smartphone to buy perhaps tissue, mineral water, a bottle of wine and stuff like that. Go to some of the local supermarkets. I'm not calling their name because they're not paying me for this. But that's a good thing though. And tip me, sooner or later, you will see that people will go around with just their phone, with no money in their pocket. But Liberians are just accustomed to having cash on them. And we're trying to get them to where they will try with a smartphone, and with the help of Tipme, you will avoid the situation of being robbed, you know, because you have your phone, just go to your Tipme account.
But then it's a steal phone in Liberia, so when they steal your phone, they carry your Tipme and everything.
No.
What are you talking?
No.
But come on, Ashford, what are you talking?
No, listen, and that's why you have the password. You have a code. When you go to use a tip, they were asking for your code before you can even use it. Somebody's Coolat S. Johnson is saying, Ashra, can you please go over that tip me information? Listen, Coolat, I don't know where you are now, but if you are in America, just go to tipmeliberia.com. All right. And you will see where, if you are coming in from your smartphone, to the upper left-hand corner, click on those three bars. And then at the very bottom, you will see a blue shaded box that says Tap Off Center. You click on the Tap Off Center, and then the various vouchers or coupons will pop up. And if you want to send $100 or $200 to your friends and relatives, you just click on that. Put in your debit card information that you will do with other entity when you go into to shopping. You know, so that's that. Just try that, and you will be just fine. So my man, I think we came for 1 hour, but we've been a little over an hour. And my brother, thank you.
Okay, let's see. Try to get the elections commission tomorrow. Commission tomorrow, and inquire if they're on the way to producing the results. It is important. We don't want a stalemate here, dragging on. You know, America has its own ongoing issues right now. We don't want to see him
tomorrow. That's what I'm gonna do. And reach out to them, you know.
And
Shelton, look, we are doing such an awesome job. You know, the people here in Liberia, the election commission, they heard about British Radio Africa, and they have a great deal of respect for us.
Absolutely. Ashford, what we're doing here is all news.
Exactly. Yeah. So we'll reach out to them tomorrow. They're listening. Don't get me wrong. They all watch the show. They love what we say, you know. Dillon, Thomas Fowler, they're friends. But they have become very competitive, and we want to make a decision. We want the Liberian people to make a decision, you know. Someone is telling you, I am going to do this for you, and the other is telling you that we want a system in place. And Shetan, the people voted in other parts of the country, and they did send a message to George Weah. George Weah became president. He didn't do a country tour. George Weah never left the city until there was election around the corner. That's when you saw George Weah going to places like Ganta, Bombing, Bone County, and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
How can you treat the people like this? These people voted for you. You sat down in Monrovia, and all you did was to visit Jamaican Resort. You know, and just play, because election was around the corner now, and you started to make it seem like you are concerned about the people. You don't do that, man. And these people are not stupid.
I keep saying it.
They're not stupid.
You can see. You know, they may not talk a lot, but they can see, Ashford. They can feel. They can smell. They can taste.
I started coming to Liberia after 15 years when I left. Since 2016. This is one of my best trips to Liberia. I have no regret coming to Liberia this time. I saw my people. We act in a way that I haven't seen in a long time. When you see people Listen, we have all kinds of Liberians. Other Liberians will say, I'm hungry, I can't get food. And Thomas Fala will say, I will do this for you. Then you had the other Liberian that said, you know what? Mommy, I was almost in tears when people were giving Dara Dillon money. Liberians.
Mm-hmm.
They were giving Dara Dillon money. Some places he went, he would get that 5-10,000. Liberians said, we ain't got much.
Mm.
But please, this is our low contribution. The thing you did for the short time you've been senator, we know that you can do more. And Shetan, I have my own quan with Dillon. Dillon is not perfect.
Mm.
I believe that Dillon has a future beyond senator. The people love this man. They love Darius Dillon. George Weah was in the same book. A few years ago, when the people say the book people giving us hard time. So they just put anybody there. You play soccer at a very high level. You made a lot of money from playing soccer. You squandered your wealth. You had the opportunity. And when the opportunity came, you regain your wealth at the expense of Liberia and the poor Liberian people. And this is what we get in return to dance zombie.
You're right.
To sleep with women in exchange for jobs. To go outside of the country and get money and come to Liberia and say, when I went out of the country, the money I got, that my own money, that not your Liberian people money. Then I mean saying no. That your own party chairman, Olamolu, said it.
Wow.
Imagine. Where is the love of country?
But how about the one that they say he sneaks out of the country to go to Ghana to Jackie Appiah?
Well, I don't have the facts for that one. But I'm telling you about what his chairman, the chairman of his party, said it. Man, go out of the country and get money. When he come out, he would tell someone to us, say, the money I got, that not your Liberian people, that my own money. I went and hustled for my own money.
And I don't know money.
He said that my own money, I hustled for it. That not your Liberian people money. Mm. Then he would sleep with women in exchange for jobs.
Ashford, we're at a crossroad. And let's hope by Friday we'll know whether we have a change in Liberia. What I said the other night, I will repeat myself quickly. If a legislative branch of government can have a lot of oppositions, it will help with check and balance. That is, if they are not compromised. It will help to bring some of these ministers for hearings, so that they can tell us what they're doing rather than just pass around and doing nothing for the country. It will help with the judicial system. But you can have the presidency usurping the Constitution and operates outside of the Constitution. And then the Supreme Court is just ceremonious. And the legislature, including the Senate, do nothing about it.
Hmm.
That's why the president in African countries become gods. Because two branches of government play to the presidency. They bow, they heed to the presidency. And that's not good. So we'll hope that many oppositions in these elections yesterday, can win, so we can at least have some kind of
accountability, some kind of check and balance is important if we have to. But you said something very, very, very interesting. I wanted to just give a jab at it. I was in a conversation with myself, and I said, what Darius Dillon has done, if indeed he becomes the next senator of Monserrate County, this guy can be the haymaker in the 2023 elections. With that kind of following, to decide the presidency. You remember Prince Johnson? Came third in one of the elections.
That's right.
And it was what he did that changed the landscape. This guy has the propensity, because what's going to happen here is that, say, hypothetically, George Weah was in the race and one of these serious oppositions come to, you know, run against Weah and they went to a runoff. If they went to a runoff, obviously, if Darius Dillon was in the race just to muddy the water with his following and he came third place, oh, come on. He can make Weah a one-term president. And so we shouldn't, you know, take this lightly. So you were right. He has a future in the country. If he sticks to his plan, if he remains the transparent guy, the guy who, you know, talks the truth, the guy who does what is right by the people, for the people, and he does those things well and continue to gain the trust of the Liberian people, not only yesterday, but going forward in his next 9 years to go.
We need to go back on his agomancy. Oh, yeah.
He can make a serious difference in 2023. And so let's begin to look at, you know, the coming days, the coming months, the coming years to 2023.
You know, Shelton, it is good that some of the things that are happening with the Lord. He's not a perfect guy. He would make mistakes. Absolutely. Along the line, but he's learning. This Dillon knows Liberian politics. He understands how the circuit of the Liberian people work. I mean, with the temperament and stuff that he would get angry, you know, a few times and say things and then would come back and apologize, but he's learning. But I'm telling you, Darius Dillon has a future as it relates to Liberian politics. Don't underestimate this young man. One of the things Dillon said the other day, he said people will get in position in the 20s and the 30s. When you don't perform well, you lose out on the opportunity and nobody want to hear from you. You say, if I want to run for office, I would not rush it. Darius Dillon just turned 50. He'll be 51 this year or next year. And what this gentleman has done in terms of speaking to the minds of the people of Liberia, he has won the admiration. And the people, at least on Sunday, what I saw, the body language, the kind of way that the people were expressing themselves because of love for country, the anger against this administration. Shelton, do you know what it means that your relative gets killed. And you can't hear anything. You have a president who called the Air Corps, called the United Nations, and said, my country is bleeding. And they listened to him when he was peace ambassador. Today, you are the president of the country. People are getting killed mysteriously. Young men have disappeared, going on 2 months. We don't know their whereabouts. You get up and dance zombie. You don't say anything. The only time you speak when you go to fucking clone church. That's the only time you get to say something. What does that say about your leadership? I know we're here for 1 hour. Now, we're here about an hour and 30 minutes. I want to get some sleep so that tomorrow...
Again, we want to be emphatic here, to be honest with you and to be honest with our viewers and listeners. I don't think Ashford or myself have any hate bone in our heart for our president, George Weah. I continue to say what I hate is how the country is being run. What I hate is when these things are happening under a leader's watch and he takes no action. He doesn't address it. He doesn't care, because that's how it comes to the people. And there's no better way to say it. Do you think that I'm not impacted by it because I'm in America? Oh, absolutely. I'm impacted by it. I have relatives, loved ones, and family living in Liberia who are impacted by it. And if their lives are on the line and there's stagnation, suffering, and degradation, and hardship, I'm the one who's going through the stress to continue to help those people. So no one hit President Weah. No one hit the bone in President Weah. I don't think that's what it is. And I don't wish evil for him or anything, but he has to step to the plate. He took on leadership of the country. And to take on leadership for the country, it means that you put yourself in the public and the people will talk. The people will cry. The people will swear. The people will have to say things, irrespective of whether you like it or not as the president and your followings, whether they like it or not. Because there's always a majority are the people who suffer. And so, President, we don't hate you. We're only telling you, you need to act. You have years ahead to your one term to make some transformation. That's all it's about. So if anyone go thinking tonight that I have anything bad to say about the president or anything, it just has to do with the leadership, the state of condition in the country, the societal ills that he's not addressing to transform our country and give us the hope that we have looked for and yearned in this man. He needs to step to the plate. That's what we're asking.
And Shelton, are you surprised why we have Juan Boudicke to head the anti-corruption bureau?
I'm not surprised because he's the one covering up.
Don't be surprised.
That's what I'm saying.
Most of the people who are heads of these autonomous agencies, you know what they're saying? They say if you get somebody credible to do audit, they say we'll go to jail for a long time. They say because it is George, we had a year tenancy. I want this amount. Bring it. These people are saying, hey, if they order us, we'll go to jail for a long time. Because there will be no way that we can give account of these monies. That's what they're saying. So that why you came, that why you wanted to be president for? Is that the pay now to the Liberian people? Shut up. You go to these election centers, no light. They're using lantern. Hold on, let me give you lantern. Let me show you lantern, man.
Listen, man. I saw you, man. You were in the place. There were lanterns. People using a phone to tally the votes. So all that money, they couldn't buy one generator, one tackle to every place. Huh? They couldn't put tackle there. Come on, man.
They are telling me this is what we have
in the 21st century.
Yes.
And they have all the time to prepare for these elections.
To count the votes. This is what they have.
And yet we're giving excuses.
Yeah, but he can afford to break down his home and rebuild it. My man, how many homes
can one man have?
Thank you.
I know that was the question. How many homes can you sleep in all?
So all the time you're playing football, you know what, Nina, you wanted to own these things?
Yeah.
And because the Liberians are so gullible, and this is what we get in return. I don't hate you, George Weah, but shame on you. Shame on you, George Weah. This is not what the Liberian people settle for.
No, you're right, Ashford. You're absolutely right. I love Weah. Weah, as a Liberian, the things he's done for the country on the sports side and all of that, I thought he made himself. He worked hard to get to where he ascended to be the world's best and all of that. But my brother, if leadership is not for you, now you enjoy it, at least just give the people country back. And after these 6 years, and let's go on. You're forced to be there. You can't do this job. You can't do this job. Ain't hard to give it up. You got at the end of the day, you know, the other people before you, you saw what happened to them. They were forcing it, you know. President Doe forced it. What happened to him? Charles Taylor forcing it. He's sitting now, you know, 6x6, looking at the concrete ceiling every day. So it's just simple as it is. All of us are not cut for everything. We are all not cut for everything. And this is not criticism. This is just speaking to truth. That's all it is. The Liberian people deserve better. We can't have these people dying for nothing. 200,000 plus people died. And yet people are still enjoying on their blood. And no accountability. How can we operate like this?
You know, and after all of this, you are trying to make it seem like the people voted for George Weah. Listen, George Weah said that he wants to regain Montserrat by all costs. But do not play with the Liberian people, Mr. Weah. Please don't. Stop asking for trouble. I saw the desperation. I saw these people. The very room that George Weah voted in. Darius Dillon had 139 votes. Thomas Fowler had 50 votes. Some of the places that Thomas Fowler is giving people scholarships and building schools for them. Dillon was performing very well. Please stop asking for trouble. And this is just the beginning. With more opposition senators.
Yeah.
Joshua will not even make it to 2023. And if he does make it to 2023, he will be chased out of Liberia. Because you know why? The missing young men are on the ballot, or were on the ballot. Electric City was on the ballot, Shetan.
I know.
Mm-hmm. Corruption was on the ballot. The root of law was on the ballot.
Yep.
Sycophancy, hypocrisy, we're all on the ballot. My man, let's go get some sleep, yeah.
Yeah, but man, we just put it to 8 o'clock. We're almost there. That's maybe 2 hours. Yeah, but you know, it's sad. That's what people writing all kind of crap. You think I got time for that? Those are the people who, you know, getting some kind of grease through what is happening in the country. Yes. Those of us who found ourselves in the country, we didn't come here because we're invited here. We came here because we're seeking greener pasture. And we had to work hard over the years to build the platform we've built to be able to sustain and survive. So if we can do it here, we should be able to go back to Liberia and make that contribution. But look at some of the people who go to Liberia, they go there, oh my man, I'm going to hustle. How can you leave America to go to Liberia to hustle? You should be leaving Liberia to go anywhere else outside of Liberia to hustle.
I'll tell you.
And some of these people left here to really go hustle. So as soon as they get in a position that money becomes exposed to them, it's all about them.
Shatton.
You tell me, how can you leave? Come on, man.
Shatton. Every money is not good money. When you love Liberia and you are in Liberia, some of the things that you see happening in your country, don't even take a dime from George Weah. Because that's what means that you're supporting some of the bad things they are doing. You have pastors. You have imams. Shelton, you have lawyers and doctors. You have all of these people. They can't say anything.
They're compromised.
You have three young men that we can't find. Whether these men have been killed, we don't even know. Shelton, when we work at ELBC, we kept it professional. We were paid for our expertise. Listen, when I interviewed Alexander Cummings the other day, Alexander Cummings asked his secretariat to say that Astro got to come to my apartment so we can do the interview. I said, no, I will not come there to him. I will do the interview via Zoom. Okay? I will do the interview via Zoom because some of these people, when you go to them, then you fall under the cloud where they can take a little envelope and give it to you. This is not what we are about. I'm supposed to be interviewing the former vice president. And I will do the same via Zoom. I'm not going to get close to them. Because at the end of the day, we are British Radio Africa, man. Credibility. Integrity. When my girl calls you for interview, and after the press conference, you see people walking, staying around just to get $20. They call it kato.
But how you tell me about kato? But
that mean now we go sit around and interview and stay around. But the reason why they can't come to us is because they know we will ask the tough questions. And we don't need a dime from them.
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
We are so passionate about what we do. So they would rather go to rookies.
Who would blow the trumpet for them.
Thank you.
And just continue to cover up things at the detriment and suffering of the Liberian people. You know? Well, if
I can't ask you the question I want to ask you, don't come to my station.
Yeah.
Stay there. Don't come to my station. Look, when George Weah, after he voted, and people were asking him questions, Shelton Have I been there? You already know the question I'm going to ask Joshua. Three missing men. Four auditors died. No money in the bank. No electricity. How do you govern this country? How do you go to sleep at night? But Joshua was lucky. I was not there when he went to go vote. And I said this, the same way Joshua puts on his pants one leg at a time, we all do the same. Some people lie on themselves just to protect Joshua. That me, Ashford Gary, would lie on myself. No job is worth for me to lie on myself. This is one of the best trips to Liberia since I've been coming to Liberia 2016. And I am enjoying this trip. I will enjoy my Christmas here. I will enjoy my new year, yeah, before I return to the U.S.
Well, you come in there, bring my New Year date on my birthday, my man.
you have billions Liberian dollars disappear. And let me see if I can, hey, boy, you will kill me. Let me see if I can tell you some of the 419 names. Mm-hmm. Now, 7th square. And then created just to blaffoon the Liberian people.
About the 25 billion? A million?
About the 25 million. Let me see if I can find some of these names, Shetan.
They talking about the money exchange bureaus they created.
Oh, my brother. Yeah. Keep say something that been funny, Shelton. Please.
Say yeah, you had it the other night. You were giving some crappy names that didn't make sense. You know, where put the money for mop up.
Those names, my brother. I mean,
and so those documents are going to be kept in our financial archive,
my man.
Can you imagine that?
These were names that is sent to the people. For example, God is able foreign bureau, meaning with God we are able to steal this money.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing past God foreign bureau.
So that the name though.
I said nothing past God, foreign bureau.
Mm-hmm.
A God would make us succeed in stealing this money. The empowerment, foreign bureau. This is our time to steal. Surprise, foreign bureau. Liberian people will be surprised. We just gave them Huawei. Convenient, foreign bureau. But what thing they'll be surprised for? And they're stupid. By making our stealing convenient for us, by making TV rogue, we are president. They went further to say abundance, foreign bureau. I say, McGill, so we are not to worry. The money here in abundance. When this one finishes, we will go to the donors' funds. Determine a foreign bureau. We are determined to flush the country down the toilet. Good rate. Foreign bureau. We get all our Jew, then the Google rate. Then the Jew then will go to China to go buy false hair and bring it back home. Stand up. Stand up, foreign bureau. But the Liberian people know when I get stand up, sir. So when the year about our stealing, they will not do
freaking. They
will not, you know, I don't want to use the word, but you know what, growing up, we in the year that what Fakoki.
Yeah,
will not do Fakoki to us.
Yeah, remember the
Fakoki. New Foreign Bureau, then a lie. Magee lie, Samuel Tue lie, George Weah lie. We are the new rich people in Liberia. Ego, we can read a nail. Go and visit that. These are the names that these people you call leaders today.
So as for me, just give me 1 minute here. For those of you, our listeners and viewers, many of you are employed, especially in the diaspora. And a lot of you may have, at one point in your employment, have an issue with your supervisor. I don't think you really hit your supervisor. Maybe it is the way your supervisor is running the department, the entity, or the way your supervisor does not care about your well-being, does not respect you. And so you sometimes get a loggerhead with your supervisor, but there's no hit booing your supervisor because of, you know, wanting to see that supervisor dead or anything. I think it is the same scenario that is happening. George Weah is the supervisor of the Liberian people. George Weah is the supervisor of the government. George Weah is the supervisor who should ensure that the country is going well. And in the absence of those deliverables, the people will be angry. The people will have an issue. The people will feel somehow. And so those of you tonight who have supervisors, that you can't see eye to eye with, is all because of maybe the way they're leading, the way they're treating you, the way they're treating your peers, your co-workers, the way they're running the department or the entity. And all you can hoosh for is that supervisor should resign, or that supervisor should find another job so that somebody else who can care, who have good heart, who understands the job, who is able to deliver, who is able to make the business or the organization grow and make profits, would be the person you're looking for. That's what I want to say. And Ashford, thanks for the night. You know, I thought it was important that we talk about these things. Tomorrow night we'll be here. Hopefully there will be the results coming up. But try to catch up then.
Thank you, Shelton.
It was good.
Yeah, always, my brother. Good night. And folks, I'm afraid it's all the time we have to be with you tonight. God willing, we will be back tomorrow night. Same time, same place. Oh, man. Gracias, Tupayenge. Zegwan Blue, Rana Jaku, and no, Chiraji. Do I win? Chance on me. I talk where you more Jimmy and Dre. And folks, please allow me to borrow the wordings of the wise men. Tough times don't last, tough people do. The heart of a man is never known until he rashes, because there's no second chance to make that first impression. Don't see okra and swallow bone. When women know your friend, black man. Trust no shadow in the dark. A bald-headed man does not walk on the moonlight. The medicine of the microphone, the golden voice of Liberia. The broadcast commissioner, the brother who doesn't eat iron, but he's definitely stronger than a lion. Ash for the giant. And now you know me, Garland. Have a good night.
komine sika na lingaka yo.
Maria Masane.
Na bamba na bamba na monte mana kokate tika na binisa o mama. Mama na bamba na bamba na monte mana kokate tika na binisa o.
Koka. Hey, 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 sugar. Ingénieur Tumba Tinkela. Oka va chercher moi.
Et ça la gamme passe la mode.
Maman,
double doublé. La mode est
mort,
la mode est mort.
Maman, double doublé.
Y'a qu'un copain sans
ma baiser
à l'idée. Ce qui au y'a le même.
Maman,
Mwana na komine sika na lingaka
Mwana
na komine sika na lingaka Mwana na komine sika
na
lingaka Mwana na komine sika na molema Mwana na
komine sika Thank you.
Kaba Shajima. Oh, you see, give it up. Mama, don't let me play.